Good morning, this is Arvind. In our previous session, we have discussed about arrays and strings. Now in this session, let us discuss about user-defined data types. After going through this session, we should be able to understand declaration, definition, and initialization of structures, accessing structure members, structures within structures, arrays and structures, and structures and functions, pointers to structures, unions, type definition, and enumerated data type. In this session, we will discuss about structures, unions, type definitions, and enumerated data types. Before that, let us know what is a structure. We see that an array enables us to identify a group of similar data items by a common name and thus facilitates us easier collective manipulation. In many programming situations, we do require to identify a group of data items which may be dissimilar type, also by a common name with a provision for accessing individual data items. C supports us a user-defined data type known as a structure, which is a method for combining data of a dissimilar type. A structure can be defined to be a group of logically related data items, which may be of different types, stored in continuous memory locations, sharing a common name but distinguished by its members. Now, let us see the syntax for structure declaration. The declaration of a structure specifies the grouping of various data items into a single unit without assigning any resource to them. The syntax of structure is shown here. The structure declaration starts with a structure header, which consists of a keyword struct followed by tag. The tag serves as an structure name, which can be used for creating structure variables. The individual members of the structures are enclosed between the curl brackets, and they can be of similar or dissimilar data types. The data type of each variable is specified in the individual member declaration. So for each and every member, we need to separately specify its data type. And these data types can be different. So for one variable, we can have different data types. Now let us consider an example, and in that let us consider an employee database consisting of employee number, employee name, and salary. Here the data items are enclosed within the curl brackets. So in the above structure, here we can see that employee is the name of the structure and is called as an structure tag. Note that some of the members like employee number, which is of type integer, name, which is an character array, that is a string, salary is of type float. So here the individual members of the structures can be variables of built-in data type like integer, character, float, etc. Not only this, they can be pointers, they can be arrays, or even other structures. All member names within a particular structure must be different. However, member names may be of the same or those of the variables declared outside the structure. So here we have to note one point. Normally the structure declaration appears at the beginning of the program file, before any variables or functions declared. They may also appear before the main program along with the micro definitions such as hash define. In such cases, the declaration is global and can be used by other functions as well. And one more key point here, the members are declared within the curly brackets and the closing braces must end with a semicolon. So here the closing braces must be ended with a semicolon. So this is also one more key point that what we need to consider. Structure definition. The declaration of a structure will not serve any purpose without its definition. It only acts as a blueprint for the creation of variables of type struct. The structure definition creates structure variables and allocates a storage space for them. So here there are two methods whenever we define a structure. So here the structure variables can be created at the point of structure declaration itself. So while declaring the structure itself, we can create an structure variable. And the other method is by using a structure tag explicitly and when required. So as and when required, we can create the structure variable. So these are the two methods that are being used for defining a structure. So here in this particular example, we have seen a structure with employee, which is having an employee number, employee name, and employee salary. Employee number is of integer type. Employee name is an character array, that is a string, and salary is of floating point type. So here the employee number occupies 2 bytes of memory, name occupies 8 bytes of memory, and salary occupies 4 bytes of memory. Accessing structure members. So here the members of the structures can be accessed by using a dot operator. So structures use a dot operator, also called as period operator or member operator. So to refer any element in the structure, before dot there must be always a structure variable. So the before the dot we must have an structure variable, and after the dot we must always have an structure element, that is the member of the structure. So here in this particular example struct student, we are having 3 members. One is a name, and the other one is roll number, and the other one is average. Now I have created an structure student S1. So this is a structure variable. Using this structure variable, I can access the elements in this particular structure as follows: S1.name. So refers to the string name. S1.rollNumber refers to the roll number. S1.average refers to the average. So this is how we are going to access the structure members. Structure initialization. Like any other data types, structure variables can be initialized at the point of their definition. So let us consider the following structure declaration, wherein I have a structure student which is having name, roll number, and average. So average is of type float, roll number is of type integer, name is an array of characters, that is a string. So here in this student structure, student is the structure tag, where here I have created one variable, that is S1. So this S1 is the variable. Through this variable, what I have done is I have initialized the values. So here the variables of the structure student can be initialized during the definition. So here what we can see, that Ravi, the Ravi value is assigned to the name, 10 value is assigned to the roll number, and 67.8 value is assigned to the average. So this is how we can initialize the structure. Arrays of structures. So an array is a collection of elements of same data type that are stored in continuous memory locations. A structure is a collection of members of different data types stored in continuous memory locations. An array of structure is an array in which each element is a structure. This concept is very helpful in representing multiple records of a file, where each record is a collection of dissimilar data items. as we have an array of integers, we can have an array of structures also. For example, suppose if we want to store the information of class of students consisting of roll number, name and percentage, a better approach would be use of an array of structures. So here I have taken an example of student. I have taken an example of student. Here the student is having three things. One is a roll number, name and percentage. So here I have taken 20 students. These 20 students, how I am going to access these 20 students is, suppose 20 students details are to be dealt with, we would declare an array of structure student of size 20, and here array elements s of 0, s of 1, so on up to s of 19 are the variables of struct student type, and thus each can store a student details. Since all these variables share a common name, that is s. So here we can access S0 of roll number. So that roll number of the first student. S0 of name will give you the name of the first student. S0 of percentage will give the percentage marks of the first student. Suppose if you want the details, roll number of the 15th student, S14 dot roll number, S14 dot name, S14 dot percentage. So in this way, we can use an array of structures. So now let us see an example. Here in this particular program, we have a structure of student. Student is having roll number, name and percentage, and we have created a structure variable S. So which is being declared as an array of structure student type, and its size is 20. So here maximum of 20 students details can be stored in it. The variable n is to collect the number of students which should lie between 1 and 2 inclusive. I ranges from 0 to n minus 1. So that's the reason I have given I less than n. The meaning of it is I values lies between 0 to n minus 1 inclusive n minus 1 in the for loop. So thereby selecting each student one by one. After accepting the number of students to be stored in x into the variable, we are going to display the student list. So this is the small program how we can use an array of structures. Now let us see array within structures. So it is also possible to declare an array as member of structures, like declaring ordinary variables. For example, to store marks of students in 6 subjects, then we can have the following definition for the structure. Structure stood int roll number, char name of 80, int marks of 6. So here within this particular structure, I have taken an array of type integer and an array of character type. So that is a string. So here I have taken, we can also declare arrays in integers. So arrays within a structure. So here, then the initialization of the marks is done like as follows. Structure student S1 is equal to Ravi. Ravi is the name. 34 is the roll number. 60, 70, 80, 68, 90, 75. So these are the marks of the 6 subjects. So S1 dot marks of 0 will refer to the 0th element in marks, that is 60. S1 of marks of 1 will refer to the first element in the marks, that is 70. So the second subject marks is 70. The third subject marks is referred as S1 of marks of 2. The fourth subject marks is referred as 68, which is S1 of marks of 3. Fifth subject S1 marks of 4, which is 90. And the sixth subject mark, that is S1 dot marks of 5. So in this fashion, we are going to assign values to the structures. Now let us see this particular program. Here the struct student is defined with the members roll number, which is of type integer, name, array of characters, marks, and array of integer with the size 6, sum which is of float type, sum which is of integer type, and percentage which is of float type. So a variable of struct students can store roll number, name, marks scored in 6 subjects, total marks, and percentage of marks of the student. In the main, X is declared to be an array of structure student. So here I have declared X, which is an array of struct student type with the size 20. It can thus store 20 students' details at max n. And I are declared to be variables of type integer. Here, n is to accept the number of students. I is to traverse the student elements. After accepting the number of students into the variable n, n students details are accepted into the variable x. Note that the nested of two loops. The outer loop, I loop, is to select each student. The inner loop, J loop, is to select marks in 6 subjects of each student. When I is taken 0, first student is selected. So x0.sum is set to 0 initially. Then the inner loop selects marks of the first student in 6 subjects and adds them to x0 of sum. So here you can see, when I is equal to 0, we are going to initialize the first student's sum as 0, and we are adding the 6 subjects marks to the sum. Then after that, what we are doing, we are calculating the percentage of marks of the student, and then it is assigned to x of 0. This is repeated for all the values of I. So whatever the n value we are mentioning, those many number of students sum and percentage values are being calculated. Structures within structure. A structure which includes another structure is called nested structure, or structures within structure. That is, a structure can be used as a member of another structure. Here there are two methods for declaring nested structures. Structure of one type are made the members of an other structure. So here in the first case, we can the structure is made as a member of other structure. In other structure, we are making it as a member. Whereas in the second structure, we can see clearly see that this is the outer structure, and in that structure we have another structure. This structure is the inner structure. So these are the two methods in which we can define the structure. So this is what is called as an structure within an structure. Now let us illustrate the with an a small example program. We have created a structure date. This date is defined with three members: day, month, and year, all of integer type. A variable of struct data type can thus represent a date. So this is a date. So here what I have done, struct student, another structure is defined with members roll number, name, array of characters, DOA, that is date, and percentage float. A variable of struct student type can thus store student roll number, name, date of admission, and percentage of student. You can call this either a date of admission, or you can also date of birth. You can say whatever it may be. You can state in the format of DOA. If it is a DOB, date of birth. If it is a DOA, date of admission. You can read it as a date of admission. In main program, what you have done, X is declared to be an array of structure student type. So here you have defined a single x value. So here I am not considering it as an array. I am taking only one student data. So I have not taken it in the form of an array. So the as we have discussed in the above, the structure is having roll number, name, percentage, and DOA, date of admission. So we see that we can nest one structure within another structure and understood how the members of the nested structures are accessed. So here, if you see that you have entered the roll number, name, and date of birth and percentage of the student, and all those results are being printed one by one. Self-referential structures. So let us see what is an self-referential structure. So a structure containing a pointer to the same type is referred to as a self-referential structure. It is useful for implementing data structures such as linked list, queues, stacks, and trees, etc. A linked list consists of structures related to each other through pointer. So the self-referential pointer in the structure points to the next node of the list. So here I have created a structure node. So this is the syntax of the structure which is having a pointer. Pointer to itself. Now let us see struct node. So the first member is an integer item, and the second is a pointer to the next node. So here that is I have represented in the picture format like this. So such structures which contains the member field that points to the same structure type are called as an self-referential structures. Now let us see what is an union. So a union is one of the derived data type. Union is a collection of variables referred under a single name. The syntax, declaration, and use of unions is similar to the structure, but its functionality is different. So in what way it is different from structure? So the common thing shared by both structure and union is both enable us to identify group of data items which may be of dissimilar types by a common name. But the difference lies in the storage location schema. In the case of structure, the number of locations allocated would be equal to the number of members in the structure. Whereas in case of union, only one location which is large enough to collect the larger data type member is the union gets allocated. So in union, you will be having a single memory location. Whereas in structures, based on the number of structure variables, so those many memory locations will get created. So here, since in union you are having only single memory location, if you are going to enter a new data, the previous data will be getting erased. So here union is the keyword, and union name is an array, is an user defined name which should be a valid C identifier. Data type is any valid data type supported by C or user defined data types, and member 1, member 2, so on up to member n are the members of the union. So the syntax for declaring a variable union type is shown here. Union, union name, var 1, var 2, so on. So as a result of this, a memory location gets allocated, the size of which is equal to that of the largest of the members, member 1, member 2, member 3. So here, whatever the members that is having the larger size out of these n members, only that will get allocated. So accessing the members of the union is similar to accessing the members of the structure. Dot operator is used to access each individual member, and dot operator except union variable is to that it is going to access to the same address. Instead of different address, it is going to access to the same address. That is the only difference between the structure and the union. So in structure you will be having number of memory locations, whereas in an union you will be having only one memory location. So that one memory location, whenever a new member is going to be, new data is going to get added into that particular structure, what it will do? It will erase the previous information. So here, what is the necessity of using an union? Because memory plays a major role. So we are going to count the computer capabilities based on its memory. So here, whenever we want to save the memory, then instead of creating a structure, we need to create the structure as a union. That is the important thing. Now, let us see what is an enumerated data type. So enumeration is also called as an enum, is an user-defined data type in C. So it is mainly used to assign names to integral constants. The name makes a program easy to read and maintain. So here, the enumerated data types offers us a way of creating our own data type. The created new data types enables us to assign symbolic names to the integer constants, thereby increases the degree of reliability and maintainability of the program. Variables of enumerated data type are very often used in relations with structures and unions. So here, let us see the syntax of enumerated data type. So here, enum, identifier, brackets open, value 1, comma value 2, so on up to value n. So enum is a keyword. Identifier is any user-defined name. It is better if the identifier happens to a collective name reflecting the set of values, value 1, value 2, etc. Or the symbolic names representing the integer constant 0, 1, etc. by default. So here, what will happen is the value 1 will be assigned with a value 0, value 2 with 1, so on. So 1, it will get incremented. So the starting value will be 0. So the syntax for declaring the variable of enumerated type is similar to that used while declaring the variable structure or union type. So here, what will happen is the compiler automatically assigns integer digits beginning with 0. So here, if you consider this particular example, true, the true will be considered to be 0 since it is the first one, and the false will assign a value 1. So t is equal to true means the meaning of t is a t value will have 1. F will have the value, t will have the value 0 and f will have the value 1. So the compiler automatically assigns integer digits beginning with the 0 to all the enumerated constants. So not only this, however, we automatically assignments can be overridden by assigning values explicitly to the enumerated constant. For example, I have declared an enum state, working state and failed state. I have assigned the value of working state to be 1. So if I am not going to assign this value, the working will have an value 0 and failed will have value 1. Now in this case, what will happen? Since working is equal to 1, failed value will be increased successively by 1. So failed will have the value 2. So this I have shown with a small example program. So in this particular program, we have taken a data type month, which is declared with 12 months names within two curl brackets, that is from Jan, Feb, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November and December. So that a compiler assigns 0 value to the first identifier and 11 to the last identifier. So 0 will be in Jan and 11 will be in the December. So what I have done, I have taken those values. So the compiler, since I have not assigned, initialized with any overridden values, Jan will have 0, Feb will have 1, March will have 2, April will have 3, and finally the December will have 11. So here ST. So these are nothing but these are variables. So these are variables. Year starting is equal to Jan. So year starting will be assigned the value 0. Year ending is 11. So since year ending I have equated to December, it will have the value 11. So when I have printed those values, we can see in the output it is 0 and 11. And the last topic what we are going to discuss in this particular session is type defined. So type defined is a keyword used in C language to assign alternative names to the existing data types. It's mostly used with user defined data types when names of the data types become slightly complicated to use in programs. Following is the general syntax for using type defined. So type defined, existing name and alias name. So current name and alternate name. So let us take an example. Here I have type defined unsigned long. Since unsigned long, very complicated, very big name. So instead of representing unsigned long, I have given a shortcut like ulong. For example, always whenever if you are in your program, if you are going to use printf and scanf commands, whenever you are typing printf, you can define type defined printf p. PF, type defined, scanf function, SF. So these are the alias names. So wherever you want to use printf, you can use PF. Wherever you want to use scanf, you can use SF. So these are the alias names what you are going to give. So the above statement defines the term ulong for an unsigned long data type. So here ulong is the name, alternate name for unsigned long data type. Now this ulong identifier can be used to define unsigned long type variables. So here the type definition can be used to give a name to user defined data types as well. So we can give this type definition to the user defined data types. So what is an user defined data type? Structure is an user defined data type. So here I have defined type defined. So I have defined the type as a type name. So this type name is the name. This is the name, structure name or alias name to this particular structure. So in this way, we can use the type defined. Something which is similar to your hash defined, what we can say. So thank you. Thank you very much for attending this particular session. Thank you.